duty, honor, country. Those three hallowed words reverently dictate what you ought to be, what you can be, what you will be. They are your rallying points to build courage when courage seems to fail, to regain faith when there seems to be little cause for faith, to create hope when hope becomes forlorn. They build your basic character. They mold you for your future roles as the custodians of the nation's defense. They make you strong enough to know when you are weak and brave enough to face yourself when you are afraid. They teach you to be proud and unbending in honest failure, but humble and gentle in success, to be modest, so that you will remember the simplicity of true greatness, the open mind of true wisdom, the meekness of true strength. And what sort of soldiers are those you are to lead? Their story is known to all of you. He belongs to history as furnishing one of the greatest examples of successful patriotism. He belongs to posterity as the instructor of future generations in the principles of liberty and freedom. He belongs to the press, to us, by his virtues and by his achievements. Yours is the profession of arms, the will to win, the sure knowledge that in war there is no substitute for it, that if you lose, the nation will be destroyed, that the very obsession of your public service must be duty, honor, country. Today marks my final roll call with you. But I want you to know that when I cross the river, my last conscious thoughts will be of the Corps and the Corps and the Corps.